I started working in game theory in the 90s because of the tremendous growth of the internet and web. There were many game theoretic issues and incentives going on into these large systems that nobody anticipated. My general area was decision-making uncertainty, so I moved slowly towards this issue, microeconomics and game theory. Game theory is a mathematical theory of incentives, collaboration, and competition. So here is a typical game that people in a city play. Every day, they start from their house, they take their car and go to their work. They select the shortest path for them. They want to go fast to their work. They don't care about the effect that this has to other people. But it is known for about 100 years that if somebody could give instructions to people in a city how to go to their work, all of them would go faster. So here we have a distributed decision making. This is game theory. Everybody decides their best strategy, but if you take all of them together, their strategies affect the delay of the others. So as a result, the solution is not optimal. It's not as good as it was designed centrally by a central authority. Yeah, the thing that excites me about game theory is that it affects all parts of our lives. And it's a field that is, for me, it is interesting and it's very close in terms of approaches and background with computer science. I'm a computer scientist and I do a little bit of game theory, but I find it very interesting because it has deep problems that are relevant to the world. Game theory plays a large role in these systems, in blockchains. For example, there are all these incentive mechanisms for miners to follow the suggested protocol. They, for example, in Bitcoin, they currently get 12.5 Bitcoins every time somebody manages to mine a block, plus the transaction fees. This is an incentive for doing the work. Blockchain is a system that is built and managed by a distributed system, by computers. They need to be paid for doing this. And if we want these systems to be successful and stable, this payment should be incentive compatible, meaning that the payment reward scheme should be such that the participants, either in a proof-of-work system like Bitcoin or a proof-of-stake system like Cardano, they will have the incentive to follow precisely the suggested protocol. Blockchain research is very exciting today. Of course, this has to do with the tremendous success in the value of these coins. But I'm very optimistic about this technology. It gives us an opportunity to do things that were almost impossible before.